welcome back to the show.
Oh, thank you for having me. I like love being here, and I love my song "Always" by The Roots. Making me my favorite. Millionaire Rounds, my favorite song.
Thank you.
I'm so happy.
I love meeting your poodle backstage.
Oh yeah.
Winnie.
She somehow makes everything about her.
Well, she's just very
so
cute.
She's so selfish.
No, she
is a queen.
I met her on Zoom.
Yes, and that's when she was puppy. That's when she was humble.
It's gone to her head now?
Oh, it's gone to her head, absolutely.
Does she think she's a star?
Of course, she is a star.
She is, well. What is she doing right now as we're speaking?
Well, if I'm on set, like I take her to my movies and stuff like that, and we're always at the studio, and if she hears my voice or sees me, she feels comfortable. But if she can't, she gets really anxious. We have a little codependency issues. We don't have to go through it.
A little bit.
But that's because of COVID. Like, I got her in COVID, and so we didn't leave the house. We were always together. So she's here right now. She's backstage.
But she didn't freak out in front of an audience or anything?
No, actually, when she was 8 weeks, I took her to a Falcons game. I was just like, you gotta get used to this kid.
Wow.
And she did. She was just like, okay, whatever. And so now she just thrives on sets, on studios. She doesn't like being at the house. She's like, I wanna go out, I wanna go to work. She knows where she's going.
What are we waiting for? You wanna bring Winnie out?
Let's do it.
Everyone, please welcome to The Tonight Show, Winnie the Poodle.
There's mommy.
Here.
Hi. Come on, let's go. Come.
She's like, I just gotta shake the nerves out.
She's just like, whoa, where's my mom? I can't hear her.
Hi, Win.
Yeah.
Hi, Winnie. It's so nice to see you.
Yeah, she's happy to be here, I think.
Now, when you are on set, does Winnie know when you're being you or when you're acting?
She knows when I'm acting and she knows when I'm actually really upset. But she's an actor. She knows when I'm upset. She knows when I'm fake crying.
Is she playing hard to get?
I swear. She knows a camera.
She really does. She's looking right at
every campaign, every photo shoot. Every photo shoot,
look at this
she
stuff.
Knows.
Look at this stuff. Who, me? She's like, who, me? Who, me? You guys talking about me?
So she's not about, like, she doesn't really care about human attention. She cares about an audience.
Yeah?
She loves a camera. So I actually, on Damsel, did a huge stunt. I had to jump from one cave to another, and I did the stunt, and she has never made a cry, a yelp. She knows when I'm acting, but this stunt was so realistic that she cried out to me because she thought I was actually gonna die. Oh. And I remember just looking at her being like, it's okay, baby. And she was just like, okay, like that really looked real,
yeah,
mom.
Don't scare me, mom.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
So terrifying. But she like somehow makes her way into, she's been on covers of magazines. She knows a camera and she works it.
She really is so cute. Well, welcome, Winnie the Poodle.
Yes.
You also, I saw your fiance Jake backstage.
Yes.
Fiance.
Yes.
By the way, congratulations. Excited.
Yes, me too.
He's a great guy, and you were telling me backstage that the proposal story, it was pretty incredible. I have not heard it yet. Do you mind sharing?
Yes. Well, I haven't told anyone this because I, you know, like there are moments, key moments, but I'm like, Fallon is the best. And also, I think this is too good of a story to not tell, but basically, Jake and I bonded over diving. We love diving. We got our diving licenses together, and one day we were on vacation and he was like, Mil, you gotta be up at 8 a.m. We're going on a dive. And I was like, 8 a.m.?
Yeah.
Dive? Like, what
it's
are
vacation,
we?
Vacation, yeah.
And he's telling me, like, we're going to the same spot we usually go to. I'm like, it's boring, let's go somewhere new. He's like, no, we have to go to this spot. So we go under and we're like many meters down and he gives me like a shell and I like turn it over and it's a ring. And I was like, and I like looked at him and he was like, I was like, and he was like,
yeah,
and
bubbles.
Then I was like, because this means up. I want to go up.
So you can't.
So that technically would mean, no, I don't want to marry you. I want to go up.
So you can't. You got to make a quick decision.
Okay. And I think it was underwhelming, but we freaked out. Anyways, he puts the ring on my hand. And as I go to show him The ring falls off my finger, plummets. Like, so fast, it was like a cinematic movie. Jake threw himself into the, like, so deep. Like, the diver was like, you can't do that. Like, your ears, you're literally, your brain will explode. He throws himself, he does a cinematic, like,
grab,
opens, and he saved the ring.
Come on.
And I truly
that's
feel,
a stud.
I know. I truly feel like it's a reflection of who he is, and I feel like we're always gonna have each other's back, and if anyone drops the ball, we got it. So, there we go.
But then that's not the end of the proposal.
We got to the top.
Yep.
And he was like, do you wanna marry me? And I was like, oh, like, yeah. I mean, yeah, that would be, you should probably ask me in person. And then he was like, you know, I bought you this ring because your mom wouldn't let me take her ring, which is the one I'm wearing. This is my mom's ring. And he was like, my mom was like, absolutely not, Jake. You're not taking my ring down there. I know you'll drop it. And sure enough, I did.
He did. So, she was right.
She was right. So but when we got up on the boat, he was like, this is your mom's ring, and I got it from your parents. And it was very magical. And his parents were there, and we just looked so disheveled coming out from a dive.
We were engaged.
Like, oh. We were like, we're engaged, but also we have to tell you this crazy story that just happened.
Like, yeah, because no one knows.
No one knows.
You're in the middle of nowhere.
We were just like, yeah.
That's so personal and great. Yeah, thank you for sharing
that.
I'm so happy for you guys.
Yes, thank you.
You're the best.
Thank you.
Let's talk about Damsel.
Yes,
this is a giant new Netflix movie, March 8th. Your co-star, Robin Wright, was here last night. Called you a powerhouse, by the way. Not too shabby.
I don't even know what that, like...
That's Robin Wright.
It's the coolest thing ever.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
I know. I just watched that, and I was just like, whoa. Like, yeah. That is so cool to even just see as, like, a description. Like, I don't know. It means so much to me.
It's actually a very physical role, too. I mean, a lot of...
Well, like, I mean, I did the stunt, though, when he literally thought I was really throwing myself into something. I mean, I've never done stunts like that before. I am claustrophobic.
Do you say no to anything?
Yeah, I'm claustrophobic. So I say no to anything that I'm in tight spaces. I have to say no. And sure enough, when I read that script... There was one specific thing where I was, like, basically crawling through a cave, but it was the size of an air conditioning vent.
Oh, no.
And I was going through it, and I said, no, I can't do it. Like, I can't do it. So I came back the next week, and they were like, can you try it again? I tried it again, but this time I had my fiancé and my assistant, like, holding my feet just so I could feel someone, like, because I was so terrified. And then the director's on the other side giving me, like, positive affirmations. He was like, you're doing great, Millie. Like, because he's Spanish. He's so passionate. Yeah. And I was like, thank you. Sobbing, crying. So when you see the scene in the movie, it's all real. I wasn't acting.
You're overcoming one of your fears. Yeah. Good for you. Yeah. Step by step. We'll get you there. So, by feet or by your hands, we'll make sure.
However,
we got you covered. Yeah. How do we set up Damsel for everybody?
Oh, my gosh. Well, Damsel is about a young woman who... marries a prince, and all seems romantic and just like a fairy tale until he shows some serious red flags.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And in fact, it is not as it seems, and it's very dangerous and very cinematic, and it's an adventure that you have to follow this young woman on. And
there's dragons involved.
There is a dragon.
I don't want to say, but there is a dragon. There is a clapping for a dragon.
There is a dragon. There is a dragon, and that is my co-star for the whole film.
Yeah. I want to show a clip. Here's Millie Bobby Brown in Damsel. Take a look.
You may make your return.
I'm supposed to carry you back.
I'm fine with walking, really. Floria would love this part.
Close your eyes. I've got you.
This is gonna crush, bud. You like that, Winnie? Winnie's a little scared. Winnie, it's good. It's gonna be all right. Millie Bobby Brown, everyone. Damsel is available on Netflix March 8th. We'll be right back with Gordon Cormier. Stick around.
Hey, hey, hey.